Hi ladies and gentlemen and welcome to IT Snippets. Today I'm going to show you how to use MakeMKV to rip your Blu-rays from disk. First things first, we'll have to install MakeMKV if you've not got it. So if you go over to your browser, in my case it's Opera, and select that, and then go to www.makemkv.com. You can click on the download link, and then select a version for either Windows or Mac OS. At the moment I'm running it on Windows, but I already have it installed at this point. So I'm just going to minimise my browser just now, and then I'm going to go and run MakeMKV. Okay, I already have my Blu-ray disc that I want to rip inside the drive, so the first thing MakeMKV is going to do is try and scan this. As you can see, it scanned it, and it's telling me that it is a Blu-ray disc, and the label is volume ID for some reason. Oh well. It's also telling me there's a newer version of MakeMKV, but I can get that later on. So, once you can see this open Blu-ray disc can be highlighted, you click on that. And it'll give it a moment, and what it will do is it'll actually analyse the Blu-ray disc for all of the tracks that are actually on it. As you can see, it's expecting this to take around 2 minutes, but it didn't take that long. So what it now brings up is a list of all of the titles that are actually on the disc. So let's see if we can expand that a little, shall we? Okay. Well, going by the size of these, I suspect that these are not actually the movie. In fact, I don't even believe that one's the movie. So what I'll do, since this is 21.2 gig, which would make sense for the film and has 33 chapters. That's obviously our main film. So I'm going to untick all of these because I don't want to rip stuff that I'm not actually going to use. Okay, and I'm now going to expand the chapter section for just now. And as you can see, it shows us all of the subtitles and the sound that's actually available. Again, I don't speak Japanese, Spanish, Italian, German, two types of French, and I do speak English, so we'll leave the English one in there for both True HD, Dolby Digital Surround 5.12. Okay, now I'm also going to take out the subtitles. This is actually going to take a moment. So, what's worth noting is that sometimes there's forced subtitles. You may want to keep them. For films like Trainspotting, where there's on-screen text, actually, you know, the worst toilet in the world, that was actually a forced subtitle, so if you take them out, that doesn't actually appear. And films like Man on Fire, for example, they're speaking in a different language, and it's subtitled. The forced subtitles would have to be there, or they just would not show up. Okay, so I've now removed everything apart from the main movie as far as I'm concerned, and the audio to go along with it. Out in the output folder we can see C:\Video\V4Vendetta. It is V for Vendetta I'm ripping, so I'm just going to go with that. Everything looks fine, so I'm now going to click MakeMKV. It tells me the directory does not exist and I want to create it, so I do. Click yes, and then just wait for it to actually process. Now again, as with ripping DVDs or any other video media, it takes longer depending on the specification of your PCs. Mine's a reasonably spec PC, and I think this took around an hour. So it really depends on, you know, your graphic card for the hardware encoding and the processor speed of your system. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to just either speed this up or possibly put a jump cut in. So there was a problem with the audio on this video, so I'm having to record this end part as a voiceover. As you can now see, it says copy complete, so we click OK. And it returns us back to this screen, so we can go up and then minimise that. And then we open our Windows Explorer. And then we go to C:\Videos, and you can see we now have our V for Vendetta folder, so if we go in there, Now see that we have a review for Vendetta.mkv. As you can see, that's around 14 gigs in size. That's a rather large file. But we'll show you how to shrink that down later on. If we double click it to open up and then jump our way through the movie, I've nixed the sound in this so that I don't get a copyright strike. But as you can see, everything looks fine, quality looks acceptable, everything's readable on screen, it's all looking good. Can't say any better than that, I really can't tell the difference myself between the original, so I'll close that down. If you liked this video, give it a like. If you disliked this video, give it a dislike too. If you get feedback on this or any other videos or suggestions for videos you believe you should do in the future, then please let us know in the comments below. And most of all, thank you for watching.